Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a Sassy Girl aroma haul. Her last pre-order I participated in because there were quite a few scents that I wanted to try. She did a pre-order for these, I don't know what these are called. Maybe it's on the invoice here. Like, oh, Breakaway Brittle. That's what it's called. And I love them because you literally, I mean, I haven't had these before from Sassy Girl Aroma, so I don't know how easy they are to break, but if they work how I feel like they're supposed to, you should just be able to break off a piece, which is always ideal for me because I hate cutting up wax. So anyhow, why did I save this? I don't know why I saved my invoice, but I did. And yeah, so that has everything I ordered on it. These were $8.75 a piece, and then Sassy Girl Aroma charges shipping like when the items are getting ready to ship, so you're never paying like more than you're supposed to. She did get new cards. I don't know why she did that, because I loved her old cards, but whatever. So this is the card here, and then that's what the back looks like. I love Sassy Girl Aroma, but I just feel like she changes her imagery way too much. Just a personal thing. I just feel like once you find branding that works, you should just stick with it. Because I'm going to show you guys. So, obviously you can see that's what her card looks like. But then this is what font is on the invoice. And then the actual brittle is labeled with that. So it's just like, yeah. But anyhow, that's neither here nor there. I'm going to show you guys what I got, because even with that, Sassy Girl Aroma is a great vendor. Her wax always performs really well for me, and I get great customer service from her. So the first thing is the sample I got. This is in Hanami, which I have no idea what that is. So I didn't look up scent descriptions, but to me, this is just like a fresh scent, but I also smell like some cherry in this really strong. And maybe a little citrus. Smells really good. Definitely summertime appropriate in my opinion. And it's really strong too. And then these little, I keep calling them the wrong thing, I feel like, Breakaway Brittle. I picked up 5 of them. She had quite a few scents that were really intriguing to me, so I felt like I had no choice. So you can see these are all blended together. I'm not sure if, I think the scent is just throughout all the different colors, but this is the first one I picked up. It's Fog Hollow, and this is Rustic Lodge Bonfire Bliss Pumpkin Pecan Waffles Marshmallow Vanilla Bean Noel. And I don't know which is which. Some of them I do know, but there was no commas there, so I'm not sure if some of those are blended together and then put in this blend. But I'm going to take these out. Sorry, because it might take a little more time or be noisy, but that's what it looks like. So pretty. So the bottom is all gray, and then you can see the top with the different colors, and this is freaking amazing, you guys. So it is very fall. I don't know what Rustic Lodge is, but I definitely smell like a smokiness. I get the pumpkin pecan waffles. It's also really sweet. Oh, it's just so good. So this is a great fall blend. If you like fall blends, I think you would really like that. The next one I picked up is Beach Night Marshmallow Fireside. Like, come on. Beach Night with Marshmallow Fireside. Like, I had to get it. So this one is Toasted Marshmallow, Sea Salt Breeze, and S'mores. Sumptuous vanilla cream blend with the comforting aroma of rich smoldering wood. So everyone knows what those two scents are, so I just thought blended together they would have to be perfect. And this one is also such beautiful colors. The colors are so vibrant and pretty. So that's what this one looks like. And this one is really strong on the beach nights, I have to say. Like, I'm not getting much of anything else at this point. There's a touch of smokiness. But, I mean, in all honesty, they're kind of this. They're not the same scent, but I mean, outside of the smokiness from Marshmallow Fireside, they're both kind of like marshmallow blends. So, which, I mean, it smells amazing. I can't wait to see how it does. If I feel like I need to amp it up with a smoky note, I'll just blend something with it. But I think it smells amazing. Next up here is Sawdust Days. And I feel like this is like an old school blend. I feel like I've seen this before. This is caramel apple cotton candy and a sweet, delicious salted brown sugar vanilla. I'm pretty sure I've seen this on her site for a really long time. So it must be a super popular blend. And let me get out of here. So that's what that one looks like. Really pretty, like raspberry color, and then the dark, like Merlot color, and purple and pink. So pretty. And this one is amazing. So right off the bat, it reminds me of what is it from Bath and Body Works? You guys know which one I'm talking about. I literally have it melting over there too, and I can't think of what it is, but I definitely get the caramel apple. It's really sweet, which I assume is from the cotton candy. I love the apple in this because it's really strong. It is so insanely strong, you guys, and sweet. And I absolutely love it. Boardwalk, Summer Boardwalk, that's what it's called. Yeah, it reminds me of that, but like on a level 100, because that is so strong. Next up, I picked up Pink Petal Tea Cake Type. And I don't know what's going on with other vendors, but I feel like Julie is always able to find those exact dupes of Bath & Body Works that everybody wants. So she found this, and it's Pink Rose Petals, Pound Cake, and Vanilla Glaze, which is, of course, the Bath & Body Works type. I was not a super fan of the soap and the actual candle. I sniffed it, but it did not really impress me. It definitely didn't impress me enough to buy it. But look at that. So absolutely stunning. And this smells so good. One thing I do have to say, though, is I am not getting a ton of, like, pound cake. Because this almost smells like a body care scent. And I've never smelled the Pink Petal Tea Cake body care, so it could very well be that. But that strong pound cake or like bakery note is not coming through in this. It does smell really good. But I wish it had more of that bakery note. And this was a pre-order, so these are still pretty fresh. They will need to cure a little bit. They could definitely change. But I love that these pieces are also small enough that if you do like want to blend something with them, you can do that and it's not going to be like too much wax in your warmer. And then finally, the last one I got is another fall blend. This is Black Cat Saw Casper, and this is Blackberry Cider Lane Marshmallow Fireside Marshmallow. So the marshmallow is amped up in this one. And show you guys this so you can see all the cool colors. And love this one. It's really so funny because you all know if you've ever had Blackberry from Sassy Girl or if you've ever had Cider Lane from anyone, those scents are both intense and you can smell them both in here and it's like they're trying to compete with each other. But yeah, you get the Blackberry. You get the Cider Lane. I'm getting a slight smoky note from the Marshmallow Fireside. I'm getting Marshmallow Fireside stronger in this blend than in my Beach Nights blend. But it smells so good. I absolutely love it. So I have to admit to you guys though, because except for this one, the rest of these I kind of just have sitting out because I didn't want to bother you putting them all back in their bags. And dude, they're so strong. Like, I think I'm getting a slight headache. So we're going to go ahead and put those up. They might not need any cure time. I may just start melting them now because, whoo, it is strong over here. So anyhow, if you picked up some breakaway brittle, please let me know what you got or what your faves are. If you picked up any of these, let me know if you really like them. I do know she has a pre-order going on right now for some different scents. And I think that one of them is a berry waffle cone type, which, again, I don't know how she's able to get these blends, but these are blends that people have been lusting after, just wanting them so badly, and she's able to somehow get them. So, yeah, berry waffle cone type. I can't remember what the other ones are. I have no intention of purchasing any more wax. I do have one more order coming from a new to me vendor that I will share when I get it. But then outside of that, I'm not picking up anything else for fall. I am starting to get overwhelmed with the amount I have. And in all honesty, to a lot of people, it's probably not a lot. But for me, it's too much. Because once I start to accumulate more than I'm able to start melting through, I just kind of get overwhelmed and I know I need to stop. So that will be my final haul. I am thinking about putting some other videos together and just see how those go. But anyhow, yes, that is it. I'm rambling now. So I will leave Sassy Girl Aroma's website down below. I think she generally always has stuff on her website. I don't think there's ever a time when she might be low on certain things, but I think she always has things on the website to purchase. If you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you want, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.